Dr. Gail Saltz, ourtime.com's relationship expert, and I'm also the mental health relationship and sex contributor for NBC's Today Show. I'm here to talk to you today about a group of myths that people tend to believe about dating when they're 50 and up. And this may be something that keeps them from coming and taking a look at online dating or just the idea of dating in general. So let's bust some of those myths today. The first myth is that there won't be people above 50 for me because most people are younger than I am and therefore there's no pool for me to choose from. This is definitely myth number one. The fact is that the U.S. Census data from the year 2010 shows that 30% of the 78 million baby boomers that are out there are single. That's a huge pool, many people to choose from. So believe me, there are people out there looking just like you and they're available. Myth number two is that I should wait to join a dating website until I'm ready to get married. Well, ourtime.com did a poll, and actually it turns out that people in this age group, 50 and above, aren't really necessarily looking to get married. They're looking for companionship, they're looking to have fun, and they're definitely looking for a romantic, long-term even relationship, but not necessarily marriage. So, don't let the idea that you're not ready to get married keep you from getting out there if dating is what you're interested in. Myth number three is that online dating is risky. The fact of the matter is that online dating is no more risky than any other form of dating, meeting somebody out at a place or being set up with somebody, because the bottom line is, until you really know someone, there is some risk involved, and you can minimize that risk by basically using some safety ideas. Those ideas, and you can find more of them at ourtime.com, are that you always go for the first several dates to a public place. You take yourself there, you take yourself home. Tell a friend where you're going. Google the person before you go with their first and last name so you can see if there's any information that you just don't like the feeling of. Make sure to try to stay away from alcohol in the beginning so that you can probably most importantly keep your judgment and wits about you so that if you get an uneasy feeling, you can leave. But the bottom line is that online dating is no more risky than any other form of dating. Myth number four is that online dating will be expensive and therefore not affordable. The reality is that a site like ourtime.com does not cost more than $5 a week to participate in. And if you think about it, you probably spend more meeting somebody for coffee. The good news about online dating, in addition to it being really relatively inexpensive, is that you can go at your own pace, that you can meet people online and talk to them so that you don't necessarily even have to go on a date with somebody if you find that they're already not for you, which is already less money spent. So it's a comfortable, go at your own pace method of dating that also is not very expensive. And lastly, myth number five is that people will judge me if I'm dating online. And I think this is probably the one that keeps most people away from online dating. And again, it is really untrue. The fact is that ourtime.com community is growing fast, more than 400% over the last 2 years, and about 10,000 people are joining daily. So people are signing up, and I think at this point in 2011, people know that, for instance, 5 out of 6 relationships have started on a dating website, and it's become very commonplace. So I think the stigma has really, really decreased. So many people are doing it, and this simply is a myth that shouldn't keep you from participating if you're interested in dating with someone. So I hope this is helpful. Go online for more advice about online dating at ourtime.com. And I hope you get out there and look around. I look forward to seeing you soon.